So National Council of Sports today is delighted to have this partnership with the Ghana Investment Authority that is looking at around four areas of cooperation. Number one is in areas of infrastructure development, being able to package the projects that we have in sport, be it academies or infrastructure development for sport, into bankable projects for Uganda, so that when we are going out, or when Uganda Investment Authority is going out of this country, they are able to show investors that these projects are bankable. What does it mean? That there needs to be clear feasibility studies done that are very professional, that someone can rely on and say, by the time this company did this study and promised that it has good return on investment, indeed it is a bankable project. So that is very, very key for us. And in this, one of the projects that we are going to start with and in the short while is going to be the redevelopment and modernization of the Lugogo Sports Complex, because it's a very strategic project for us as a country to be able to get to a level where we can host international sports in all indoor sports and even some of the outdoor, you know, sports. So this is going to be very, very key, you know, for us, that they are ready. They are saying they are ready to even help us in the feasibility study for Lugogo Sports Complex. But also, most importantly, that they are going to move ahead and map out land in the different industrial parks. Because in our discussion earlier on, we indicated to them that for us, our factories, as much as they have so many industrial parks opened up, our factories for talent development are academies. So we need land for academies across the country. So in the industrial parks that they do have, we wanted the fringes of the industrial parks to have land mapped out for sports academies, so that if you have private companies that are coming to invest, or individuals to invest in academies, they have land. Or even us as government, as we plan to start investing in academies, we have that land mapped out, which they have said it is clear and it's noble for us to do as far as academy is concerned. But secondly, on that same note, to map out land for investors that want to invest in the manufacture and of equipment for sport and apparel for sport, because we are right now relying a lot on importation of specialized equipment for sport. We are saying there needs to be an import substitution. We need to be able to manufacture all this equipment locally from our own manufacturers here. And this is going to be one of the ways where they will map out. But also in the future, we need to look into the incentives with them that can be given to people who are investing in these specialized businesses of sport, be it manufacture of equipment, be it infrastructure development, so that we are able to pull many. Why? Uganda has so many youth. Over 75% of our population are youth. We need to engage them in sport, and we need to also develop their, you know, to develop their talent and skill through sport. So we are happy for this partnership, and we believe that moving forward we'll be able to achieve so much through this partnership that we have with UIA. Other areas we